What's cooking? What's popping, everybody? It has been a goddamn minute since I made one of these videos, or just a vinyl related video in general, and today I am so damn excited to bring back one of these videos to the channel. We are going to be talking about three Vaporwave albums that I would love to see get the vinyl record treatment this year in 2020. I've done a couple of these videos in the past, as many of you may know who's been with me for a while now, and it's really interesting going back to those old videos and seeing which albums actually did get a release on vinyl. I'm gonna link those videos in the description below if you want some more of that imaginary vinyl goodness, and feel free to join along as always. Let me know in the comments below which albums this year you would love to see come to life on vinyl record. In the scene these days, we are definitely hitting a point where everyone isn't buying absolutely every single thing that gets dropped on vinyl. I mean, there was a time I would say in like late 2017 going into all of 2018, definitely, and most of 2019, where many Vaporwave vinyl record collectors would pretty much soak up everything. Anything that got dropped right on site, they would pick it up. And I know personally, I haven't really copped anything in a couple of months now. And not that there isn't good things coming out, but I have a pretty goddamn solid amount of Vaporwave or just vinyl records in general, and I needed to calm down a little bit. But I think a lot of people are doing that too. No one's really just jumping at everything anymore. And I mean, when there's so many, you know, labels just doing the whole vinyl record craze to the Q rates or crates or however you pronounce it. There's a big Q, so I'm gonna always say it's Q rates. But there's just vinyl from all over the place at every corner, and I don't even know where to start anymore. However, I always find it fun imagining albums I've loved or recently discovered getting the vinyl treatment, from how the physical pressing itself would look to the jacket art. And what better way to start off this countdown with one of my favorite releases of all time, a business casual classic. A straight up mating call to anyone who's a sucker for those 80s vibes, Childhood by the artist of the same name is a Vaporfunk classic that I think would look minty fresh, reborn as a physical. Dropping back in mid-2013, Childhood has become a serious sleeper pick these days, a many times forgotten classic that holds everything we love about simple sample treatment, breezy production, and a light touch on the, at the time, yet to truly be established future funk formula that we saw running wild in like 2014 to 2016. Tracks like Show Me feature the perfect blend of dusty texture and reverb to delicately bring the sample used into a new life form. Drums are often light and airy. The track Got Me Girl, perfect example of this, that runs through without any crazy fills or anything like that, and it keeps your body and soul locked into this one steady groove from start to finish. Childhood's production is as light as a feather, extremely delicate with your emotions, and here we have it on a vivid turquoise blue vinyl pressing, replicating those poolside moods we all wish we can escape to. And a big shout out to my main player, Dead Disc Drive, for creating the vinyl mockups used for these videos. He also did the ones in past videos as well, and they just look simply stunning every time. With a front and back jacket art replicating the simple bliss of the album itself, that minimalist touch would pop really well on any of our record shows. Business Casual has done some vinyl record pressings in the past, mostly known for their incredible job and handling of the 100 Mornings vinyl pressing everyone seemed to gobble up back in the day. I think John over at the label would hammer it home bringing this thing to life if he ever decided to backtrack the label's incredible catalog of releases and give something the vinyl record treatment. Next up, listen to me, DMT Tapes FL, legendary label, we already know that. They house hundreds of classic releases from Danny Mason back in the day to Waterfront Dining, and still, Vito, who runs the label, has proven to show nothing but immaculate consistency, with his frequency of uploads on the label representing artists from all over the world, giving them a chance and giving them a spotlight. If there is one wish I'd have in 2020, I would really love to see Vito put some gloves on and get in the ring of the vinyl production game. There are so many releases on DMT Tapes FL that I think would just look super smooth on vinyl. Hell, DMT Tapes FL could even do like quarterly vinyl box sets with all the releases they have. It would seriously be cool, and I mean, these days you gotta stick out with your releases if you want to sell anything with the abundance of vinyl and just releases in general in the scene. And if anyone would be able to do something like box sets or something, I think the hundreds and hundreds of selections to choose from over at DMT Tapes would definitely be the way to go. So obviously, you can tell my next pick for a vinyl I'd love to see this year will be coming from the luxurious, beautiful DMT Tapes FL. And my pick for that goes to one of their most recent releases, Forest Frontiers by Sim Tycoon. Now look, Roller Coaster Tycoon is easily one of my favorite games of all time, so I can definitely say my love for the game and just seeing a screenshot of one of the levels as a vinyl pressing would look pretty dope. So just for that, I would love to have it. I think if this is remastered and remixed to sound proper on vinyl, if you go listen to it now, it's so cruddy and really only fits as like a digital experience, but I think it would be cool. It's more of just a novelty pick than anything, but hey, I don't care. It would be fresh as hell to me. Forest Frontiers is your classic crunchy vaporwave, samples compressed and then blown out of proportions to make it sound like it's coming from a half-working Game Boy Advance you picked up at a yard sale. Track number two, Welcome to Forest Frontiers, is such a jolly little jingle. It's one of those like Blue Resort Bomberman 64 video game tracks that are just so uplifting and a joy to listen to. Or how about track number eight? Let me catch my breath for this. Concessions, Refreshments, Souvenirs, Park Maps, Umbrellas. That's the name of the track. You know, that track to remind you of all the things you never bought or set up in your old Roller Coaster Tycoon save files because you were too busy half building those caterpillar roller coasters so the cars would fly off and crash. We were all sick in the head. Here we have a gorgeous vinyl mockup of that album with an all over print of that Forest Frontiers landscape, a showcasing of the never ending expansiveness of these beautiful computer generated terrains the game would conjure up for us. The physical vinyl itself, a green splatter variant with some water at the center to spin, a wonderful little nostalgic physical to add to your collection if it were ever to see the light of day as a vinyl record. Before we get to my final pick for this list, please make sure to drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't so already. I got some big things planned for 2020, and I want to have you here for the entire ride. Let's head back on over to Business Casual once again for my third pick of this countdown, one of my most frequently played Vaporwave albums of 2019, easily. The charming and ever so romantic Exotics by VCR Classic. Dropping in the late summer of 2019, Exotics is relaxation distilled and brewed into audio form. Wonderful splashy drums and crystallized synths, a heavy dosage of vinyl warping on all these tracks make this thing feel like an ever-growing side-to-side trip down the memory lanes of your childhood. This album is what the highest end of technology and luxury would be in like 1998. It's so innocent and heartwarming. I absolutely love it. 15 beautiful classic vaporwave tracks at your control. I first discovered this album when surfing Vapor Memory on YouTube, and ever since I did, it's like the perfect album to put on while you're taking a shower. Seriously, go take a hot shower after this video. Put this thing on, you're gonna feel like a million bucks. You're gonna feel great. With such a beautiful purple-orange gradient in the palms of our hands, the split color treatment does the job wonderfully if this thing were to be released as a vinyl pressing. There really isn't a lot of split colored records in the scene. One I could think of right away is like the Vapor one. Forgot the name, but I'll put a picture of it right now on the screen so you'll be looking at it. So this one would be cool to have as it would not only be different, but look extremely royal and first class with these rich and suave colors. This album is a banger in and out, a much needed retreat to be taken if you are searching for some classic vapor to soothe your soul. 2020 is here, baby, and I wonder what it will make of the vinyl craze that is seeming to slow down in the scene. Yes, there will always be those like empire building type releases that will always draw in a crowd of hungry buyers, but the days of every record getting bought up in mere minutes, it really seems to be over, and that's okay. That being said, what albums do you think would still do a great job if they were to be released on the vinyl format these days in the vaporwave scene? Let me know and everybody else in the comments below, and until next time, I love you so much. Thanks for watching. We're gonna have a killer year. I got so many things planned for you guys, so make sure you stick around. Also, head on over to my Patreon if you want to contribute to the channel, help keep it going. I got a lot of cool little rewards over there, and it just helps me, you know, get to my goal of one day being able to do Pat Chennington full time. So for anyone who signed up on my Patreon account, I love you so much. Thank you so much. And if you're just watching it in general, this video, that's cool too. I still love you. I love you all. Anybody, everybody in this world, I love you. Okay, I'm gonna shut up now. Sorry guys. I love you. Much love. Your boy. Thanks for watching. Pat Chennington.